Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Tinder Tuesday. Please do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe, as well as share, so that we may grow the family. Yeah. So today we're going to be doing things a little different. I'm not going to be telling you a story time. I'm going to be compiling some of the worst conversations I've had on Tinder, or with people from Tinder. Yo, 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 they want to know. Let's just get into it. So this guy and I matched on Tinder, and obviously we would have matched on Tinder because it's Tinder Tuesday. Besides the point. Anyway, we matched and we were just talking in general, and then he asked where I was from because he said I didn't look South African. So I was like, oh, okay, cool. I'm Zimbabwean. So he was like, oh, are you part of this tribe? Didn't know what that tribe was, so I was like, no, I'm part of the Shona tribe. He's like, no, I actually meant the Shona tribe. So I'm like, okay, cool. He's like, do you know that the Shona tribe stretches like their clitorises and they make them bigger?
Look at you.
So I was like, what? And he's like, yeah. So I was like, dude, left the conversation, went to my friend who's also Shona, and I was like, to her, babes. And she's like, no, I've actually never heard of this. I don't know if guy's just being freaky, if he's lying, it could be a thing, but like, I've never heard of it. Went back to him and I was like, actually, I don't know what you're talking about, but like, yeah, we move. We left that part of the conversation and then we went on to talking about my eyebrows. So he's like, I like your brows. So I was like, thank you. He's like, well, I like hair. What does that mean? So I was like, in what sense? And he's like, weird thing about me is I like my woman bushy down there. I don't mind being bushy down there. I don't mind it being a man's preference, but the fact that he likes hair in general, he started with my eyebrows, guys. Red flag. So I'm like, oh, okay. We finished the conversation on Tinder and we end up exchanging numbers. I do not know why, but it happened. So he's then like, you're good. So I was like, yes, I'm good. And then he's like, okay, cool, I'm good. He tells me his name. So I'm like, hi, whoever. And then he's like, I'm good, Nana. What are you up to? So I'm like, I'm doing some work at home. And you? And then he was like, are you alone? So I was like, no. He's like, can I see you? And I was like, not now. He's like, I was gonna come sneak in. So I was like, where? At my mother's house? Nope. He was like, okay, can I see you, babes? And I said, no. He's like, okay. So I was like, maybe after we meet. He's like, Then he decides out of nowhere to send me two crooked ass dick pics. I've never seen a penis bend like that, guys. It was literally like a right angle triangle. So he was shaved and I asked, so why are you shaved? I don't even know why I asked that, guys, because like there were other questions I needed to ask about. He's like, do you like it bushy too? And I was like, I don't mind, I'm just asking. And then he's like, oh, okay, well, I'll keep it there then. So I'm like, do what you want, I don't mind. And he's like, no, I'll keep it for you. So I'm like, lol, why? He's like, because I want yours to be bushy for me. So I was like, lol. He's like, I video called you to show you since you don't want to show me yours. So I'm like, to show me what? And then I was like, I'm working. He's like, I'm masturbating and I want you to watch. So I was like, no, thank you. I'm good. Goodbye. Blocked him, moved on with life, and I was like, peace. Jesus, turn in this energy in my life. I don't know, guys. I should have left it at like, but guys, saying you like someone's eyebrows is very innocent. But like at the part where he talked about grand clitorises, I should have been like, peace, like we're out. But like, we live and we learn. Conversation number two. This one really got me. There's this guy that's a friend, quite popular within the Joburg scenes. And he put out on Twitter the other day that someone was catfishing him. So I'm on Tinder a lot. I hadn't seen this catfish yet, but then it came one day. Me not thinking that that profile was a catfish, I thought it was him. And when I see someone I know on Tinder, I normally just swipe them so we can just like get it over and done with. Whether they swipe me back or not, that's fine, but I just want the algorithm to remove them from my swiping preference. So we matched. So I'm like, hi, Mang Mang, because that's his name. And he's like, no, this is whoever. So I was like, oh, okay, cool. So then we exchange numbers and then I message him, I'm like, hi, so-and-so. He's like, baby. So I'm like, how are you? He's like, I'm well. who is this? So I'm like, it's Cheryl from Tinder. He's like, hi baby. So I'm like, did you sleep well? And then I asked if I could have more images of him, because like, something's not making sense. You can't not be that guy. Like, you can't say your name is John when your pictures are Michael. It's not making sense. So I sent him more pictures of myself, and then he sent me 2 images of himself, which were not him. I'm actually gonna ask the guy, the actual guy, if he'll give me permission to put images up of him so you can see him versus the other guy. If he does, then so be it. If he doesn't, guys, they do not look anything alike. It doesn't make sense. Anyway, he tells me I look beautiful. I'm like, thank you. So I'm like, oh, and this, sending him the picture of the other guy. And he's like, yes, it's me. Angle view, pre-lockdown. So I take a screenshot of that guy's pictures on his Instagram without his name, and I send it to this guy. And I'm like to him, so this is you? And he's like, yes. So I'm like to him, how? He's like, no, I gained weight after lockdown. Why are you gonna lie?
But why y'all got to lie?
Firstly, you're way shorter than this guy. You're round. Like, his stuff in general is round. He wasn't big, but he's round. Whereas the other guy is lean, tall, and slim. The body builds are totally different. Mind that your nose is and your face. I blocked him and I was like, I don't have the energy for this. Like, why lie? For what reason? Why catfish so that then we swipe and we match, but then you send me your real pictures after? Just didn't make sense. On top of that, guys, he's not even ugly. Like, I don't know, it didn't make sense, but like, we lost that situation, blocked and deleted, and we moved. So I'm exploring whether I am a polyamorous or a monogamous person. Monogamous being like having one partner, polyamorous having multiple partners. I've changed my Tinder preferences to everybody and anyone, and like, it's open, as well as being pansexual. Anybody that I'm attracted to, or anyone's personality, like, you know, you got a winning chance. Anyway, so I matched with this couple on Tinder, and they say they're just looking for someone to have fun with. I'm like, okay, cool, let's move. So it's the wife speaking on the couple's profile. She says, morning, how are you? Did you read our profile? So I was like, morning, I'm well and you're excited. She's like, all good, thank you. So would you be interested? So I said, I am interested, but can we first meet in person to see if we have chemistry? She's like, of course we will. Where do you stay? So I was like, Rivonia. She's like, we stay in Centurion, Uval Lord. I think that's Afrikaans, guys, I don't know. She's like, do you have fantasies or any fetishes? My fantasy is to watch my hubby lick and play and sex other women in front of me, and I join in. English, guys. So I was like, no, I don't. That's exciting. She's like, do you shave? What turns you on? I was like, well, I shave when I want to. I said, making out, bondage, foreplay, being watched, and my nipples being aroused is what turns me on. She's like, well, my hubby is a dominant and I'm a submissive. She's like, we both shave. So I was like, how old are you guys? She's like, I'm 33 and he's 41. So I was already like, okay, out of the question. These people are way too advanced for me. But I carried on with the conversation. She's like, my hubby has a panty fetish. So I'm like, what's a panty fetish? And she's like, well, hubby loves to keep a woman's worn panty. So I'm like, oh, okay. And she's like, would you let him keep your panty? So I was like, people are selling their panties on the internet. So I was like, is he paying for it? Underwear is not cheap. She's like, yes, that would be arranged. So I ignored it and I was like, is that you and your husband in the picture? She's like, yes, it is. I was like, this is a definite no. She then asked how I get wet, and I was like, I don't even know how to answer that question. If a person is arousing another person with a vagina and they know what they are doing, then maximum wetness can be reached for anybody. She's like, lol, fair enough. And my hubby knows how. So I'm like, okay. So she's like, what panties do you wear? What's your favorite position? So I was like, different types and doggy. She's like, okay, nice. Do you know shades of gray? So I was like, yes, I do. She's like, well, that's how we are. He is my master and I am his slut submissive. So I was like, I know what a master and a submissive are. Hence the BDSM thing. She's like, yep. She's like, and I love being his slut. So I'm like, I'm happy for you. She's like, okay, thank you. What else do you like? And I was like, money and alcohol. She's like, don't we all like money? And I was like, well, not all people do like money. She's like, okay. So I was like, is there anything else that you want to know? She's like, are you on the pill? So I was like, yes. And then she's like, hubby's got a pee fetish as well. So I was like, please elaborate. And then he was like, he loves a woman's pee to watch, feel, and taste it. So I was like, oh, okay. And he's like, especially when he licks pussy and just starts to pee in his mouth. So I was like, cool. She's like, would you do that? And I was like, no, I wouldn't. And she's like, okay. So I was like, what else does hubby like? And then she's like, well, I love it when hubby eats my pussy when I'm on my periods. So I was like, oh god, no. Guys, and then she unmatched me. she unmatched me. I think she got that I was playing with her. Like, I think I was enjoying it a little too much. It was really funny. I just didn't think that the conversation would go like that. But yeah, I got to experience it. At least I never got to experience it in person, because I imagine a guy is like to pee on me. Sir, please. But anyway, that is a compilation of my worst Tinder conversations that I've had so far. I have had worse ones, but I haven't saved them. These ones like really just shocked me, so I did like save them. But I am on Tinder constantly, so they may be more that may top this. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Comment down below which one you think was the worst of the conversations, and if you would have ended the conversation earlier than I did, which I think a lot of people would have. But anyway, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, as well as share, and come back again. Bye.